Hi, and welcome to Inside Auburn Hills. I'm Stephanie Carroll. Today's segment is going to focus on education and, more importantly, the successes of some students from Avondale High School. We're going to be talking about their academic achievements over the past year and how wonderful it is that Avondale High School is in Auburn Hills and how we can celebrate those successes. Avondale doesn't only serve Auburn Hills residents. It also serves residents from Bloomfield Township, the city of Troy, and also Rochester Hills. And today I have with me Michelle Imbrunoni, the assistant principal at Avondale High School. I would like to thank you for being here today.
Thank you very much for the invitation.
We're going to talk to some students. We have six students here today who've been recognized by the National Merit Scholarship Program, which is a great achievement. And I understand that it's really been a banner year for Avondale.
Absolutely.
And despite education cuts and things that are happening, Avondale continues to see higher test scores. The students continue to succeed.
Absolutely. Student achievement. And when you said banner year, Stephanie, absolutely, by far. With us, we've got six students today that we're recognizing. We also have four students who have special recognition, receive special recognition and scholarships from Central Michigan University. And student achievement is really the focus of what Avondale does and what we do best. And I have always said that this district, in the 2 years I've been there, is truly the hidden gem of Oakland County.
Absolutely, I would agree. I really believe that having great schools in your community makes it more vibrant, and it really gives purpose and meaning to the community.
Absolutely. It's the cornerstone of any great community. You have a strong foundation, and once you have a strong foundation, it's like a strong house. Anything can be built up.
Absolutely.
And the students that we're recognizing today, we have are very privileged to have them in the class of 2011. The National Merit Recognition is a very rigorous and prestigious award, and the process to be recognized is very difficult. It starts out with basically a volunteer test that the kids actually sign up for, and they come to the building on a Saturday and give of their own time to try and place. It's not the type of test you can study for or take a prep session for. It's basically an aptitude test versus the other forms of achievement tests that most people recognize and are familiar with. So it really is testing their verbal and their math recognition. So for them to score so well and to do so well, it just really makes us very, very proud.
And I wasn't really that familiar with the program itself, so I did some online research, and I was amazed that over 1.5 million students start in the process.
Absolutely.
And then the number is reduced to, I think, about 15,000.
And that's national.
And that is national, you're right. And we are proud to have with us today three finalists.
Absolutely. And I keep saying absolutely because their achievement is just inspiring. You're awestruck by what kids are able to do. And as you said earlier, in the face of cuts throughout the district and legislators posturing and all that stuff going on, we've got kids who are focused on academics, who understand the necessity for student achievement, who have a strong base of support in their families, and understand that Avondale is a community where they can thrive and do well and continue to achieve and be successful.
Mm-hmm. And I think that plays into the mission of Avondale, to instill that lifelong learning in the students. And what sort of programs or initiatives does Avondale have in order to instill that in the students?
Well, everyone's trying to create a program or a foundation that students can be ready for the global community, whatever that means. The great thing about Avondale is we continue to teach kids it's okay to keep learning. And, you know, post-secondary institutions, whether it's through ASVAB testing that we're going to initiate next year so that kids have a better understanding and a better gauge of their strengths and weaknesses. It's started with ACT prep sessions that we run through our academic center at the high school that we're very proud of our achievements. And you're right, we are. We're literally blowing the rest of Oakland County right out of the water with our achievements. And it's because these kids understand the expectations, they have a strong support system, and we've got programs at Avondale High School where kids can thrive and be successful. So we're very proud of that.
The city of Auburn Hills has a long-standing relationship with Avondale School District, with the elementary schools, with the high schools, and it's been great. We've seen the district grow and continue to have these wonderful successes. So what do you feel sets Avondale apart from the other school districts?
I think you said it best, Stephanie. I think it's the sense of community and the parent support that we have. We have roughly over a little over 1,200 kids, and we are small enough to meet the needs of each and every individual student, yet large enough to offer what the students need, whether that's extracurricular, our clubs and organizations. We are definitely very well grounded in the community aspect of the Auburn Hills community and outlying areas. The kids work tremendously hard to give back to the community through volunteer efforts, whether it's Hearts for Haiti, Make-A-Wish, Making Dreams Come True for Children Who Are Terminally Ill, giving back to the Salvation Army and local charities, Grace Centers of Hope. Our kids are grounded with the idea to try to make the world a better place, and that comes from the upbringing from their parents, support from parents, and support from our business members as well in the community. So we're very proud of them.
Yeah, I continue to be amazed at the student involvement in Auburn Hills. I run into students at the community center. They're doing Meals on Wheels. I mean, they're helping with, you know, a lot of things. And I think that really says, you know, a lot about the teachers and the staff at the high school, instilling those values in the students so that they can carry them forward into the community.
Well, and it gives them, you know, the teachers and the staff are looking for vehicles so that kids understand how to make the world a better place. And it starts local, and then you have that outreach ability. We don't discount any idea or opportunity. We keep looking to make the world a better place. And quite honestly, that really does set Avondale apart from any other district.
Well, we have six students, the real reason we're here today, who've been patiently waiting to tell us about their achievements. But first, I wanted to take a moment to recognize two students who couldn't be with us today. Danielle Grace and Joseph Seriano, both from Auburn Hills, were unable to join us today because they had a prior commitment. But I also wanted to recognize them and congratulate them in their absence. So, the students, how are you today? Good, good. What I'm going to ask you to do is state your name, tell us where you're from, maybe your involvement in the community, a favorite class, and what the future holds for you. So why don't you go ahead and start us off?
My name is Skylar Leto.
Okay, where are you from, Skylar?
And I'm from Auburn Hills.
Welcome.
And my favorite class, I'd have to say, is AP U.S. History. And I will be attending the Honors LSA at the University of Michigan.
Congratulations to you.
Thank you.
My name is Kathy Chow. I live in Troy. My favorite class is AP Biology. I'm involved in the National Honor Society as a secretary, as well as helping with tutoring a lot. And I plan on going to the University of Michigan, Ann Arbor.
My name is Jenny Zane. I live in Troy. My favorite class is AP Studio Arts. I'm involved in Amnesty International, and I was the vice president of Diversity Club this year. And I'm planning to go to University of Michigan, the honors program in LSA in the fall.
And before you pass the mic off, I understand you also had another recognition. Why don't you go ahead and tell us about that?
This year I won a silver medal for photography in the 2011 National Scholastic Art Awards, so pretty exciting.
Hi, my name is Suresh Drangesh, and I live in Rochester Hills. My favorite classes in the past have been biology, physics, and calculus. And throughout the community, through Avondale, I've been involved in tennis, track, sometimes I've been involved in theater, National Honor Society, etc. And I'm going to be going to the Massachusetts Institute of Technology next year, and I will be studying material science and engineering and management sciences.
I understand that you also received another recognition. Why don't you go ahead and tell us a little bit about that?
Sure. I received an award. I was named as a regional finalist this year in the 2010 Siemens competition for math and science. And basically what it is it's different innovations that are coming together, different people who are trying to make projects, who are trying to help the community through math and science. And it's a competition that's held every year in which we present a thesis, and that thesis is judged by several judges. This year it was Notre Dame at the University of Notre Dame, and I was recognized as a regional finalist there.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
I'm Robert Bruin. I live in Auburn Hills, and my favorite class was probably biology, but my favorite part of school about the senior year has been the theater after school program. It's just really a great, awesome thing to do. We have three shows a year, and it's, yeah. I'm planning to go to OCC, Oakland Community College, actually, this fall for 1 year to get my freshman year for free because my dad teaches there. And then after that, I'm going to be going to Michigan State University to get a degree in biosystems engineering.
Hi, my name is Dhananjaya Premawardena. I live in Rochester Hills. My favorite subjects throughout my high school career were AP Government and French. And I am planning on going to U of M, the LSA program, to study pharmacology. And my favorite extracurricular activity was serving as the communications director for the National Honor Society. And to go along with Mrs. Imbrunoni's theme of giving back to the community, one of my favorite experiences was being able to head up a book drive where we were able to raise over $22,000 worth in books in just our small community.
Wow.
It is breathtaking when you take a step back and really kind of get the full picture.
It is, it is. What you have achieved is truly, truly remarkable, and you should be proud. I know I am.
I will second that. We're very proud of all of you.
I know you've worked very, very hard. I think I saw online, you know, $1.5 million. And even cooler, I guess, is the fact that we have three finalists in our midst. Which three of you are finalists? Raise your hands. Congratulations to you. That is truly, truly remarkable. Thank you for being here with us. But before we wrap up, was there anything else you wanted to add? Maybe, you know.
Well, on behalf of Avondale School District, which has approximately 3,800 students attending our schools, I just wanted to say thank you to the parents and to the business community for always supporting us in our efforts, for supporting our students, and for making Avondale truly a great place to be.
Thank you. Thank you so much for being with us. And great. I appreciate your time.
Thank you.
We are having our 7th annual open house for the Department of Public Service. It's a day for us and our employees to show the public what we do. We're telling our story and how we serve the public. We believe that the public, we're kind of out of sight, out of mind in a lot of ways, especially where the water and sewer system, storm drains, even buildings are concerned. Roads are a little more obvious and in the public's view, but trying to give them a good overview of everything we do for the city, take care of the city's entire infrastructure.
I notice there's a lot of students here. What do you hope they get out of their time spent here today?
Well, I hope that they get a good understanding of what the Department of Public Service does for the community, the type of service we give, and possibly they'll be interested in maybe becoming a public service employee one day.
Danielle, do you try to make it a fun day for these kids as well? Describe some of the activities taking place.
Absolutely. I think that kids learn best when they're able to get their hands on things. We like to let them into the vehicles. We let them see how the machines run. We do have one event where they get to use metal detectors and find things in the dirt. It's fun for them, and it helps them to learn a little bit more because they get to actually do what we do for a day. So, yeah, absolutely.
We love to come because it ties in so well with communities. The children learn all about the work and the different people that have to help out to keep the community running smoothly, where the water comes from, how the roads get plowed on our snow days.
You think the kids are having fun in addition to learning?
They love climbing up into the trucks. They love searching in the sand for different items. And this year, the best part is probably going to be the food.
I decided to go on a field trip with my granddaughter. She goes to Graham Elementary.
Why come to the DPS? What do you hope they learn from their visit here today?
Exactly how the water comes from Detroit to this area. They're learning about the sewage and how Auburn Hills actually works. How they take care of our community.
Some of the things you have to admit look kind of fun.
I think the kids really enjoyed it. I was kind of skeptical at first, but I really enjoyed it. It's very, very, it's a lot of fun.
Having tagged along, do you feel you're learning some new things while you're here?
Yes, I am. I've learned about just how this department actually works, and I'm enjoying it.
These employees are very skilled workers. They're no longer considered the ditch diggers of the past and people leaning on shovels and whatnot. They are very skilled in what they do and very technologically savvy, up with the times, and we are focused on providing the absolute best service possible for the community at the cheapest price. So we have all that in our mind, and we hit it every day.
If someone wanted to learn more about what happens at the DPS, how would they go about doing that?
Well, they can check out our website at www.auburnhills.org and look at the Department of Public Services section. It describes everything that we do. You can always stop by, give us a call at 248-391-3777. We'd be happy to tell you what we do here. And we do this every year, so the public is welcome to stop by.
On May 19th, dignitaries and residents of the city of Auburn Hills gathered together to celebrate opening day of the 2011 Farmers Market.
Well, I'd like to welcome everybody here today for our second annual Farmers Market. The weather's great, so be sure you take advantage of all the vendors that are here. And I would like to personally thank the sponsors, really, of the Farmers Market, Genesis Credit Union. We got Linda Zybeck and her administration people here that come out to see what they really are sponsoring here. And also, without our TIFA department in the city, this would not be available also. And we have the chair of the TIFA, Clarence Bennett. And I would like to thank you for participating here. We have the Avondale Pep Band under the direction of Dan Burnett. Give them a big hand. They're really, they're pumping us up for the enthusiasm that everybody's going to have as they visit the vendors here. So without that, any further ado, we're going to cut the ribbon and open up the vendors for you, and good luck. Oh, and this year, no rain on Thursdays.
Yeah.
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 Would you like to?
I want to know why you're not. Okay.
You can. All right, here we go. On three?
Sure.
One, two, three.
Woo!
The market will be held every Thursday from 3 p.m. to 7:30 p.m. through October 20th. Located at the southeast corner of South Squirrel and Auburn Roads, vendors will offer a wide variety of flowers, plants, produce, baked goods, arts and crafts, and even kitchen services such as knife sharpening.
It's a nice area and a nice location, and so we were looking for another weekday market, and that's what brought us here. You get to just intermingle. It's just such a free, open air feeling, and I like the outdoor markets a lot better than the indoor ones. We do all organic produce. We have homegrown organic popcorn. We have farm fresh eggs. We do mixes and then all the produce. And then we also have a CSA, which is a community supported agriculture, where people join the farm and they get a weekly share of the produce that's in season. And we start that from mid-June right through to the end of October.
So how does that work? From a consumer's standpoint, what are the advantages of that, and how does it work for them?
Well, it allows the farm members to be able to help support a family farm, which is what a lot of people are trying to do these days, just support local and support know their farmers. It allows them to prepay for a whole year's worth of produce the fall before, and then come to market and get all their great stuff.
The blending of our olive oils and balsamics, they go with the vegetables so well. You know, it's a great pairing. It's a good place to be to sell our products. And next door to a bread place isn't bad either.
What do you think of the Auburn Hills Market? Is it your first year here?
This is my first time here, and I'm very impressed so far for the very first time for the year. There's a lot of people that's buying. There's a lot of vendors, and that's good to see. I've been to a couple this year that was first time, and they were nowhere near as busy as this, nor as many vendors. So I'm quite impressed.
Again, the Farmers Market will be held every Thursday from 3 p.m. to 7:30 p.m. through October 20th. For more information, visit auburnhills.org or call 248-370-9400.